Hi again, Tony here. Another clip, another nice unboxing. Let's start with the first column, and we are having four beautiful models here. And the first one is made by Luxury Models, and it is a hammer. A very interesting hammer. First time when I'm seeing one of this type of hammers, but nevertheless a quite nice one. So this is how it looks in the box. And I am showing this model to you first in the box because I noticed that the door hanger from the front right door just went out and it is in the plexi, so I will need to open it carefully now. Usually this kind of accessories can be fixed. I just need to add a little drop of glue and to press it back and it will be fixed without a problem. Very nice model, quite detailed, this pickup truck from Hammer. As you can see, the color is great. The exterior details are great. I really like those big wheels Hammer has. Really nice details on the in the back, of course. Quite nice details on this model. You will have the spare wheel under the truck here. You'll have the radio antenna. Quite nice details for this Hammer. I really like this type of model, even if I prefer, to be honest, the Hammer H2 or H1. This one is a great model as well, and especially a great model car. I hope that you are not hearing some background noise, but if you are hearing that noise, it is just one of my neighbors doing what is best known in Bucharest, and to be more specific, he is doing some drills in the walls. So great. Moving to another car, this is a very special car, a car that I found out about only through Model Cars, and because I've seen this model car. This is the Persu Experimentale Limousine, or how you should say it in Romania, Persu Automobil. A great and very interesting design from 1920. So it is 100 years old, this car. One piece from the 333 pieces made by Autocult. Autocult has this habit of making most of its models in a limited edition of 333 pieces. And this car has a nice history. So it seems like Persu was a Romanian engineer that went to school in Germany, in Berlin, to technical school. And he noticed that the car with the best aerodynamics features should have a shape of water drop. So he designed this car from his own funds. He received two brevets for it, one in Germany and one in the States. And in 1924 he made this car from his own money. This is a one-off, very interesting design, as you can see. It was the first car from that period that had the wheels inside the chassis, the carrossery of the car. And for, again, 1924, this was something new. And with the engine that he received from AGA, Berlin, he managed to have a top speed with around 20 kilometers per hour, better than any car with the same type of engine. He also did 120,000 kilometers with this car before returning and donating to the Technical Museum from Bucharest, a museum I went in the pandemic period. And that was a good opportunity for me to make a picture of this car. Unfortunately, it doesn't look like this anymore. This is how the car looks like when it was functional, but the museum staff didn't do anything with it in order to make it look as it was. And as you will see in the picture that I will put in a few moments, it looks quite bad. But the history of this car is quite interesting, a crazy engineering. At that moment, both Ford and General Motors were interested in buying the brevet from engineer Persu from Romania. So, quite a nice achievement, even if it didn't went to production. But for me, at least, it was a good opportunity to learn something about this car. Now we will move to a car that everybody knows, and we are talking about a Pagani made by GT Autos. A very nice Pagani, not an extra premium model, but with a very, very nice color and quite decent details. It is stated on the plate that it is a limited edition, without saying how limited it is. It has a very interesting type of pink. Very rarely I buy pink cars. I think that this is the first one that I have with this that is pink. But this pink has something special in it. It is not any regular pink. That being said, it has an issue that one of my viewers noticed. I didn't notice, to be honest. And that issue is that the front rims are placed backwards and not as they should be. If you are looking to the back wing rims, this is how they should have been mounted on the model car. But aside of that, the model car looks very, very good. And this is something that I can easily fix when I will have time or desire. The interior is nice. You can have big visibility on it, but it is quite simple. Only one black and yellow combination, something that I don't expect from this type of Pagani. But nevertheless, a great model with a very nice, a very good price. So it was something around 20 euros, maybe less. And this makes it a good addition. And it has the quality control pass. Probably the guys from the quality control pass forgot to look at the rims. Great. Moving to another GT Autos model. This time we will have a Lamborghini. Both cars from GT Autos were, I bought them from only one reason, and that was the paint. If the Pagani was in a very nice pink color, now this Aventador, it is in a very cool purple and black combination, as you can see, and with the left mirror in the Italian flag. Usually on a Lamborghini, you'll see the Italian flag right here on the side, or if it's a Veneno, right here. But in this case, they decided to put the flag on the left mirror. And this is something very, very cool. I also like the plate number. Check it out. Come on. Yeah, you should see it now. And it's very funny. Very cool car. The interior is also black and purple, so a very cool addition. You'll have the decent engine details, decent details. The brake calipers are also purple, so very cool car. Maybe Joker in his spare time had the Lamborghini Aventador, who knows. We know that Batman has one. It is not here, but I have the Lamborghini Aventador that Batman had, so who knows, maybe this is one that Joker had. Another Pagani, but this time this Pagani is made by Almost Real. And you can see the difference between Almost Real and GT Autos. First, the Almost Real cars are almost 3 or 4 times the price, so you should expect better quality. But when it comes to small details, you should really appreciate this kind of details that Almost Real model have. In this case, we are discussing about Pagani Huayra Roadster in a very, very cool looking red. It is limited edition to 1008 model cars, as you can see right here. So not the most limited edition ever, but still only 1000 cars for this model. is not something that you can find so easily. The paint is perfect. You can see some small details of the engine right here. Nice interior. You'll have more details. You can see the steering wheel, you can see the board. Very cool details on Pagani. He is quite known for this type of details on his cars. Great P0 tires, great red brake calipers. I really like this type of four exhaust pipes placed in the middle, in the up middle of the back of the car. Very, very, very cool designs. And if you want, it's not something that I wanted, but if you want, you can take from here the roof and place it on the car, and now it will not be convertible anymore. So you'll have a lot of choices. The stand is also cool. If you notice, it has some carbon fiber wannabe leave a stand on it, so it can give you the impression that it is from carbon fiber. Very nice small details on this car. It makes it worth the extra money. Now we will move to a family car, a very nice family car from Abrex. Of course, if we said Abrex, then we are meaning Skoda. And in this case, this is the Skoda Superb. Not the latest model of Skoda Superb, because I'm pretty sure that another model appeared meanwhile. But nevertheless, one of the newest versions of the Skoda Superb. I will also have the old Skoda Superb right here. So, quite a difference, I can say. Nice family car. It has a black interior, as most of this kind of new cars has. Quite nice details on it. You'll have the logo on the steering wheel. You'll have every type of logo that you'll need to have on this type of car. I'm quite pleased with this model. Very, very nice details. Nothing to complain. So, this is one. And now we will move to the one of the previous generations of Skoda Superb. But when I say previous generations, I really mean previous, because if this one was made, I don't know, I think 5 or 6 years ago, well, the one that I want to present right now was made in 1948. And the design of this is really, as the name states, Superb. Very nice model. Another old Skoda with the steering wheel on the right. I don't know exactly why. I'm not sure that the persons from the Czech Republic used to drive on the right side of the road at that period of time, or if this was a car for England. But nevertheless, the details are very nice. I really like this combination. I don't know if it's burgundy or just a very nice type of brown, but the paint is very cool. I really like the spare wheels that we have on each side. Very cool aspect. This is a limousine, and you can see that because between the seats of the driver and the seats in the back seats, you'll have that glass wall, so for privacy. So this was a car for VIPs, and that makes me again think that in the past Skoda used to do more luxurious vehicles, and they were not focusing on cars like they are focusing right now. Very good quality for money products. But hey, they know best. Good. Moving to another limousine. This is more straightforward limousine, let's say like that. A very, very nice and very long Rolls-Royce from TS Minx, or True Scale model. True Scale model, especially for the 164 scale collectors. True Scale model is the big brother of the Mini GT models. A very, very cool manufacturer with lots and lots of details. Usually these cars, the wheels on this car do not roll, but other than that, the details are perfect. So if you are a big fan of the Mini GT products, you might like these True Scale models as well. And in this case, this Rolls-Royce looks absolutely perfect. you'll see that this silver sport limousine from 1991 has details of a VIP car. You'll have the Rolls-Royce statue on the in front of the car on the grill. You'll have it is a design that makes you think that this is bulletproof, especially if you're looking on the back window. But nevertheless, it is a very, very nice car with windows in the back for privacy. You cannot see anything in it, but with lots of details in front of the car, you'll have a very nice board and very nice board details. Quite an awesome limousine. I'm a big fan of this type of cars. Well, I'm kind of big fan of cars in general, if you are having in mind how big is the variety of models in this collection. From true scale models, both of them. This is a McLaren 570S. A cool thing about true scale is that usually they add an extra layer of plastic protection, something that I really like. The packaging is quite typical true scale. Okay, so the 570S, it was not the flagship of McLaren, but nevertheless, a very cool and very fast car. And from my perspective, it looks absolutely gorgeous in this silver. I quite like silver cars. My friend from minichamps.ro is quite a fan of exotic colors. The crazier the better. Me, on the other hand, I am more, let's not say old school. I don't want to think of me like old school, but silver or gray, it is the perfect color for me when it comes to a car. So I love this McLaren in this color combination. Another McLaren, this time we are discussing about the 675 LT. LT meaning that it has a long tail, a fantastic color. It is not silver or gray, but it is a color I cannot refuse when it comes to a supercar. Look at it. This dark red looks absolutely amazing. Being a true scale model, it means that the details are top notch, and they really are. The brake calipers, red brake calipers, are really cool. I love those details. The interior details are there. You can see some of the engine details, of course. Those exhaust pipes, very nice. All things about these model cars are awesome. I'm a big fan of true scale models. Usually, and as you've seen until now, I like to stop on 10 model cars, and we have 2, 4, 6, 8, 10 model cars. But in this case, I want that the last part of the unboxing to be with only Hot Wheels models. Therefore, I will unbox these 4 extra models as well. And this one is a muscle car made by Vitesse, American Classic Series. This is the only Mercury that I have in my collection. Mercury Cougar from 67, sorry. Very cool paint on it. It is, probably it was like this. I'm not sure, but the color is very nice. You'll also be able to have to see some interior details. I like that wooden steering wheel. Very, very cool looking part of this model car. I like the rims. The brake details could have been better, but hey, Vitesse is not known for how detailed it is. That being said, this one has an opening bonnet or hood, and you can see that very cool blue engine. And this is an extra point for this Mercury. Very nice detail otherwise. Unfortunately, I don't have many more Mercuries. It's not like they made a lot of models compared to other American manufacturers, but still, this one is quite nice. Good. Moving to a British car, this time another Vitesse model, but we are going to discuss about an Aston Martin. We managed to get it out finally. This is the Aston Martin Vanquish from Vitesse. It is one of a limited edition of 870, something quite rare from Vitesse, but I will take it. a great British racing green. Well, I'm not completely sure if this is the exact British racing green color, but for the sake of it, having in mind that it is a British car and it is an Aston Martin, let's say that it is a British racing green. Very nice details, not a premium car, but very nice details. You can see on the stand that it is a limited edition model. Maybe that's why it has more details that it will usually have on a Vitesse model. Nevertheless, quite nice aspects on it. You will be able to see the brake calipers, quite nice details on the front headlights, very cool exhaust pipes, nice interior, very clean and very visible interior. You'll have the seats in two-tone combinations. Cool details on it. I cannot have complaints when it comes to this model car. The second to last, we will move to a Japanese car right now, and we will have a GTR, a very cool Nissan Skyline, sponsored by Zexel from 1992, made by HPI Racing, one of 1,504 pieces, so another limited edition with very nice details. HPI Racing makes some great model cars. This might look a little burnt, so let me close the light. Okay, now we can see it better. So very nice generation of Skyline, very cool details on this model car. I like that you'll have only the driver's seat on interior, a very cool driver's seat, very cool details whatsoever. You'll see the roll cage in, very, very nice looking Skyline. Okay, so now we are going to open the last model of this clip. And because it has a golf livery on it, I will need an extra moment from you to change my t-shirt. So be right back. Fuck. So, cool story. I just talked with you for like 10 minutes. And after that, when I was preparing to close the clip, I just noticed that I didn't start the camera, so I was talking by myself. So let's go back to the last model car from Greenlight that doesn't have a card box right now, because I did an unboxing without filming it. Smart me. This is a very cool Jeep Wrangler with a golf livery, hence the t-shirt. A golf livery that reminds me of Mark Smith. I recommend you checking out his channel. I will actually leave a link in description of this clip. He has a very vast, actually it has the biggest golf collection I've ever seen until now on YouTube, on a 1/64 scale. Great collector, great diorama, absolutely fantastic diorama, and I'm pretty sure that he also has the 1/64 version of this Jeep in its collection. This one is a Greenlight model, very nice detail. I like the front bar here, I like the wheels, very cool that it has also a spare wheel, even if you can easily see that the spare wheel is smaller than the wheels on the car, but hey. And if you want to see an extra thing on this Greenlight model, you can take the roof off and now it's ready for the beach. And also you can see the interior, even if it's all black, it has some very nice details on it. So pretty nice model, very nice addition to the collection. I'm quite pleased with this model. Now, if you are wondering where all the models from here went, well, aside from changing the t-shirt, I moved all the model cards in the vitrines right here and right there to have a better view. And now I need to end this clip, wish you all the best, and prepare for the next clip where we are going to unbox some very cool Hot Wheels models. So cheers, stay tuned.